Hello friends, yesterday we have seen voltage to current converter. Now we will see current to voltage converter using op-amp. Here you can see the diagram. Current to voltage converter using op-amp with grounded load. So before getting into this, first we will try to understand what is the need of having a circuit like current to voltage converter. So as I told in previous video, in most of the industries we need to measure the different physical parameters. It may be a temperature, pressure, density, anything. So for that we used to have sensors. Sensors will measure any parameter and it will give its output in terms of either current or voltage. Say for example, one of the sensor is giving output in terms of current. You can take the example of a photodiode. Photodiode will measure the temperature and it will give the output in terms of current. Now, if I want to store this output value into a system such as data acquisition system, usually we will call it as DAQs. Now, the problem with this is I cannot directly store current into the system, or I cannot store the value of that current, because most of the data acquisition systems take the value in terms of voltage for storage purpose. So for this reason I need to convert this current into voltage by having a current to voltage converter in between here. Then you can store this into this data acquisition system. So now coming to the process of conversion. Conventionally, what we learned earlier in we call it as passive circuits. Passive circuits where only we use resistors and capacitors. Here we are not using any active elements like op-amp. So here what we have did, if you connect a current source in parallel with a resistor, simply it will be converted into voltage, right? So this current I input will flow through this resistor R to give you, say I1, give you voltage. Now if I connect a load across this circuit whose voltage measured is VL, say current IL or I2, you can say. Now ideally the amount of current which has been converted into voltage should be available at this load resistance RL as VL. What I am trying to tell, whatever the amount of current which is converted into voltage, full amount of that voltage should be available in load RL. But practically this will not happen. There will be a drop in such circuit, drop in the load resistance. If you want to write the equation for this circuit, you can see output voltage or load voltage, whatever you call, VL will be this current I input divided by parallel combination of this resistor, into parallel combination of this resistor, RP you can say. Current into resistor. This RP will be R into RL divided by R plus RL. So now you can see or else if you want to write the equation in terms of current, you can say this I equal to, you can make this cross multiplication. Okay, in this equation you can easily see that there is a dependency on load resistance, the value of the voltage which is available at this load, which is dependent on load resistance. Ideally it should not happen. So can we have a circuit where the dependency on load resistance can be eliminated? Look at this circuit. Here, this is a circuit for conversion of current to voltage using op-amp with ground loaded, load grounded, you can see. Here, if you want to go through this circuit now, you can easily see that the positive terminal of the op-amp is grounded and for the negative terminal input voltage is given. So you can say this as a inverting type of op-amp. As the positive terminal is grounded, by the concept of virtual ground, your negative terminals at this point voltage, because here voltage is zero, here also voltage will be zero. 0 volt because of the concept of virtual ground. Now one more thing, the op-amp will not have any input current, it will not take any current at the input terminal. So ideally I am speaking, so whatever amount of current I input is flowing, it the same amount of current will also flow through the resistance, because there is no flow of input current to this op-amp. So the same current will flow here. So if I apply KCL at this point, I can simply write IL is equal to IR. Now what is IR? IR is nothing but this voltage minus this voltage divided by this resistance. So it will be 0 minus V0 divided by R. This is I input is equal to IR, this. So therefore, I input is equal to this thing. Now, you can write like this, V naught equal to minus of I input into R. So you can see there is a linear relation, or there is a relation between V naught and I input, where there is no dependency on load resistance RL. There is nowhere RL present in this equation. So if you set the value of R, you can easily convert the whole amount of current I input into output voltage V0. So like this, you can convert current to voltage by using op-amp. Now you can list few of the applications for such circuits. Mainly in photodiodes. Photodiodes will take the temperature and they will give directly current as output. Such cases you can use this application, and you can use even in the digital to analog converters. In this diagram only, if you see, if you put a photodiode instead of a current source, say this is a photodiode, you can make such photodiode symbol. Now this photodiode will act as a current source whose output current will be IPH. The current flowing through this diode is IPH. Now your equation becomes simply IPH is equal to IR. IPH is equal to 0 minus V0 divided by R. V0 is equal to IPH into R. So the amount of current which is generated by photodiode can be converted into voltage like this. So one more thing, such circuits, you can see here in the diagram, input is current, output is voltage. Input is current, output is voltage. Such circuits are called as transimpedance type of circuits. Transimpedance given by Z, output divided by input. Output is voltage, input is current. Transimpedance type of circuits. So that's all. I hope it is clear. If you are having any doubts, please comment in the comment section. Thank you.